Hello everyone, this is Richard Cespedes, and I want to talk about music, and I want to talk about how music is you know, connected to beauty being a concept, you know, and how fighting is a the fear of fighting, or what's considered weakened individuals that can't fight. They're all connected together, and music's connected to all those things. And I want to talk about a subject of music, how and why music affects the brain the way it does. And in some way, I read this small article about how music affects the brain and how it affects it positively, and it opens up, and how the sound affects the brain in a positive manner and releases calmness or enjoyment or whatever. And the way I see it is that the reason why the brain gets affected by music is because the individual that's hearing it is probably in a certain percentage, probably 25 to 50%, they're allowing that pleasure, they're manifesting that pleasure within themselves. It's self-manifested. The young children and the older adults, they want the music to come into them and to affect them. They want the music to affect them. And it's also because every decade, children are being born. Every new decade, you'll turn children being born. And like, for example, if you're born in the late 50s or the late 60s, and you grew up in the 70s, you know, and you're kind of like 8 or 9, close to the end of the 70s, whatever music came out then, you're going to enjoy. Why? Because as a little child, you're not judgmental. You don't close yourself off to things. So you allow those different sounds to bring you joy. You're just an open door that just lets in things. You just open, you let light in, you let enjoyment in, you know? And so whatever the trend is of that time, you just let it come in. You know, that's what, that's why music works, because people they're manifesting the pleasure within themselves. They're releasing the endorphins themselves. It's not the music. It's the fact that they want to be a part of something, and that because the music is fashionable, in some cases, not all cases, they want to feel like they're a part of something within that era, so they allow the endorphin or their certain feelings or certain thoughts to emerge within themselves. The music is nothing more than an idol, just a flag that just goes up, and then you just kind of like it's like an idle switch, you know. It's just like a false switch. It's just like it's just something that pops up, and it's like, you know, it's something that's, it's complicated. It's an emotional, sociological thing that lies within the subconscious of the kids and people that are older. And music is nothing more than a little flag that pops up, and then you just kind of allow that flag to, you know, the flag basically pops up, and you that flag allows you to control your emotions and to create pleasure, you know, when in reality you can create those pleasures and those positive thoughts without the flag rising. Music is nothing more than just a reminder to just enjoy life, or that you're a part of something. That's what music is. Music is nothing more than a part of a trend or part of an era. You know, and people are the ones that are allowing those emotions to arise within them. It's not the music. It's the concept of the music. It's the concept of music and what it represents within the era. You know, it's the trend of the music. It's wanting to belong, wanting to connect to the now, wanting to be a part of something that drives those emotions so wild in the endorphins to be released, you know. That's why, you know, And no matter how music changes in the future, that will always be the case. It will always be the case. And how old music affects us is the same way. Because we are reminded from what the music in the past represented. The concepts, we allow that to affect us like films. We allow to create a certain plots in the film.